Hi, my name is Kenya Stubbs, and in this video, we're going to be talking all about motion, different types of motion, how we can view motion on graphs, and real-life examples of motion in our everyday life. Stay tuned. First, let's discuss uniform motion. The definition for uniform motion is an object that is moving in a specific direction, whether it be north, east, southwest, at a constant speed, no matter what that speed is. To visualize what uniform motion would look like on a graph, I'm going to insert a picture. Take a look, and then we'll discuss it later. So even though we only looked at one type of graph, this one, all three of these can resemble uniform motion. Why? Well, each of them show the object going in a specific direction and at a specific constant speed. Now we're going to take a look at a real-life example of uniform motion. We're going to watch my mom drive down the street at a constant speed and in the same direction. Take a look. So in the previous two videos you watched, you saw the truck moving in a constant direction at a constant speed of 10 kilometers an hour. Now that we've discussed uniform motion, let's take a look at linear motion, which is a little bit different. Linear motion is a one-dimensional motion along a straight line. So while we know the direction is constant, the speed can be a variable. Let's take a look at a graph that shows linear motion. So as in the graph you just saw, linear motion can be accelerating or decelerating, or going in a straight line like uniform motion. Let's take a look now at a real life example of linear motion. My dog running down the street in the same direction, but the speeds vary. So in that video, you saw him run in a straight line. However, in the beginning, he took some time speeding up, and in the end, he slowed down. In the middle, he was running at approximately a constant speed. Now let's take a look at circular motion. Circular motion is the movement of an object along the circumference of a circle or rotating in a circular path. The graph for circular motion looks something like this. This depicts circular motion because you can see the object accelerating and decelerating as it goes around in a circle. Let's take a look at a real-life example once again, this time of race cars. So this example shows circular motion because as the race car goes around the track, both speed and distance are variables. Next, we're going to take a look at oscillating motion. Oscillating motion is a motion of going back and forth repeatedly. Now, take a look at this next graph. It's a little bit different than the ones we've previously looked at. This one displays oscillating motion. So this shows oscillating motion because you can see the rise and fall in acceleration as the object swings back and forth. Like such. We're going to take a look at an example of oscillating motion in a pendulum swinging in the clock. So this shows oscillating motion because you can see the continuous back and forth of the swinging pendulum. Next up, we're going to take a look at acceleration versus deceleration, the definition and how it affects motion. So acceleration and deceleration is the rate of change in the velocity of an object. Pretty simple, right? We know that if an object is accelerating, it's increasing in speed, and if an object is decelerating, it's slowing down. Let's take a look at a graph that shows acceleration versus deceleration. This graph shows acceleration because you can see the speed's increasing. And this one shows deceleration because you can see the speed is decreasing. Next up, let's take a look at gravity and how it affects motion. Gravity is a force that attracts objects to the center of the Earth. You're probably wondering, how does gravity affect motion? We'll take a look at the following video.
2, 1.
The basketball and the medicine ball, being dropped at the same time, hit the ground at the exact same time. This is possible because of gravity. Gravity was pushing both objects toward the ground at the same speed. You know, without gravity, motion, uniform motion especially, will be almost impossible to achieve. Interesting, all the different types of motion. There's way more than just the three I showed here, but I found these three the most interesting. There's uniform motion, which is constant direction, constant speed. Linear motion, which is constant direction. And oscillating motion, which is a motion which goes back and forth. Now we took a look at acceleration and deceleration, how that affects motion, and gravity as well. I think throughout this lesson we've touched on mostly what motion is, how it affects our life every day, and how we can view it on a graph. Thanks for watching my video. Bye!